हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, मैं बसंत यादव, आज इंग्लिश क्लास 12 में द मोस्ट रिप्रेजेंटेटिव पोएट ऑफ विक्टोरियन एज एंड पोएट लॉरिएट ऑफ यूनाइटेड किंगडम अल्फ्रेड लॉर्ड टेनिसन द्वारा लिखा पोयम द पासिंग ऑफ आर्थर को मेरे द्वारा इंग्लिश में एक्सप्लेन किया जा रहा है। इसे गंभीरता से समझने का प्रयास करें। इसको सरल से सरल शब्दों का प्रयोग करके समझाने का प्रयास किया जा रहा है। पोयम को शुरू करने से पहले इसकी थीम जाने। इन दिस पोयम अल्फ्रेड लॉर्ड टेनिसन शोज फर्म फेथ इन गॉड एंड प्रेयर द ग्रेटनेस ऑफ गॉड इज द चीफ आइडिया फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग टू द एंड गॉड इज द सुप्रीम मास्टर ही फुलफिल्स हिमसेल्फ इन मेनी वेज मिराकल्स एंड वंडर्स फीट्स आर रॉड बाई प्रेयर्स। लेट्स बिगिन द पोएम द पासिंग ऑफ आर्थर एंड स्लोली आंसर्ड आर्थर फ्रॉम द वार्ज द ओल्ड आर्डर चैन बिल्डिंग प्लेस टू न्यू एंड गॉड फुलफिल्स हिमसेल्फ इन मेनी वेज लेस्ट वन गुड कस्टम शुड करप्ट द वर्ल्ड। इन दिस लाइन्स द पोएट्स पॉइंटेड आउट दैट किंग आर्थर टुक पार्ट इन ए बैटल एंड ही वॉज सीरियसली wounded there. He asked his loyal knight Sir Bedivere to put him in the boat. When the boat started sailing, Bedivere was very sad. He was worried that the tradition of knighthood of Round Table, which was started by King Arthur, would come to an end with the demise of the kings. Here, King Arthur advised his loyal knight not to be sorry, become change is the law of nature. King Arthur tried to console the faithful knight Sir Bedivere, who is very sad at the time of King Farewell. He explained that world system is replaced by a new one. Change is the law of life. The new system takes the place of the old system. His system may be very good and useful, but it will corrupt the world if it is allowed to continue for a long period. God used various methods to carry out His will. Thanks. Comfort thyself. What comfort is in me? I have lived my life, and that which I have done, may He within Himself make pure. But thou, if thou shouldest never see my face again, pray for my soul. In these lines, the King Arthur says to Sir Bedivere that he should console his own heart. He could not give him any consolation. His life is over. He wishes that God may accept his deeds. They will then become pure. Perhaps he will not return. Sir Bedivere will never see him again. In this case, Arthur requests Bedivere to pray to God that he may grant peace to his soul. Thanks. The next stanza, more things are wrought by prayer than this world dreams of. Wherefore, let thy voice rise like a fountain for me night and day. In these lines, the poet pointed out that fatally wounded Arthur had lost hope of his life. Therefore, consoling the sad knight Bedivere, Arthur requested him to pray for the peace of his soul. He pointed out that prayer had supreme power. Prayer could not miracles in the world. Even the impossible things beyond our thought are possible with the great power of prayer. As such, Bedivere should do prayer for others. His voice of prayer should be a continual inflow as fountain water. In these last lines, for what are men better than sheep or goats that nourish ए ब्लाइंड लाइफ विद इन द ब्रेन इफ नोइंग गॉड दे लिफ्ट नॉट हैंड्स ऑफ प्रेयर बोथ फॉर देमसेल्फ एंड दोज हु कॉल देम फ्रेंड्स फॉर सो द होल राउंड अर्थ इज एवरी वे बाउंड बाई गोल्ड चेन्स अबाउट द फीट ऑफ गॉड्स बट नाउ फेयरवेल। In this last line, the poet pointed out that the King Arthur consoles Bedivere and explains the value of prayer. Prayers work wonders, so men must pray to God. Comforting Bedivere, King Arthur says that without prayers to God, man is like a beast. Beasts are blind to sense of prayer, but man has mind and spirit. He knows much about God, even then he does not raise hands for prayer. Prayers have divine and supreme power. Man must pray for himself and for all his friends. Truly speaking, the whole mankind is linked with God by the golden chain of prayers. So prayers are necessary for all mankind. With such an advice, the king bade farewell to his loyal knight Bedivere. Thank you.